And then you're talking. Say amen. Glory to Jesus. You start to outgrow the fact that maybe I am qualified for this job.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
You outgrow the fact that maybe, just by chance, I am anointed enough to carry the gospel.
Jesus.
Amen.
You outgrow the fact, and you begin to realize that everything God said about me, yeah, check one, check two, check three, it's true.
It is true.
Say amen.
Amen.
So you start to outgrow your own limitations. Yes, I'm supposed to be a millionaire. Yes. So guess what? This job ain't making it. I'm outgrowing my limitations. I'm looking for other things that's going to make it happen.
Yes.
Outgrow your own limitations. Somebody say, outgrow your own limitations. I wish you'd hear me in this house today. Outgrow your own limitations. Know that you can do it if God said you can do it.
Amen.
Know that you can make it happen if God said you can make it happen. I mean, like, for real, for real. If he said you can do it, you can do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If he said it's yours, guess what? No matter who else has it, no matter who else wants it, it belongs to you. And can't nobody else have it. You outgrow your own limitations. Say amen.
Amen.
God, that's a good place to give him some praise. I said that's a good place to give him some praise. I'm not holding myself back anymore. Glory.
Yes.
Although while we experience these things, they cause us to grow. It does not nullify the fact that growth is not easy, and that growth sometimes is very painful. Say amen.
Amen.
It also allows us to know that if we are willing to say yes to the Lord, although the pain, and I'm not going to tell you no lies, it may not get less until you get out of it.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing we do know is that when we get to the other side of it, it's going to be well worth right now.
Yes,
hallelujah.
It's going to be well worth right now.
Now, hallelujah.
What's on the other side? Is there no comparison to where we are right now? Give God some praise. As we begin to look at the scriptures, Isaiah chapter 48, I said, give him some praise. I'm talking about the future. I'm making gains. Through all the pains, I'm still making gains.
Hallelujah.
Isaiah chapter 48. As we begin to understand what God has said to us through his word today, hallelujah, and what he has for us, as we're understanding what season we're in a season of spiritual growth, numerical growth, and financial growth. Understanding first that God is all-knowing. He knows everything about us. He knows everything about our situation. He knows our end from the beginning. Say amen. He knows our future even before we even had a past. He knows everything about us. Say amen. In verse number 4, which is a very important verse, God says to us, he says in verse number 4, he says, because I knew that thou art obstinate, and thy neck is as iron sinews, and thy brow brass. What he was saying, obstinate means that you were stubborn and not willing to change your action or thought. So God is saying to us, because I knew, sorry, then you were stubborn, I had to do this. Because I knew if I told you go right, you still wasn't going to listen.
Yes, sir.
I had to do this.
Amen.
Because I already told you what to do,
amen,
and you just wouldn't do it,
amen,
I had to cause this to happen. Because guess what? God's perfect will is going to be done in your life one way or another. You're going to either get it by you going, or he's going to take you there. Either way, it's going to happen. Say that. So he says, because I knew that you were obstinate, because God knows us and he understands us, it takes us through seasons to break our will. It gets us to the most vulnerable seasons in our life. And he gets us to those places all just to break out of them. He gets us to those places because he wants us to know that you were never in control in the first place. You were never in charge in the first place. You were never the person that was the head honcho in the first place. You was not the HNIC in the first place. I just made you feel like the hell. So he takes us to these places and then he breaks us. Glory to Jesus. And then you start looking at everybody funny around you because you think it's that person that's causing you to break. And you think it's that person that's causing you to break. And God is behind the scenes the whole time saying, you know what, I'm doing this one. Because your head, you know what I mean, you're obstinate. Your head is hard as a brick. Lord, I remember being younger. Amen. Sometimes somebody would say, your head is hard as a brick. Meaning you don't listen, so you got to learn the hard way. Obstinate. Say amen. Some of you are in some situation because you just have been obstinate. Hard as a brick. Say amen. So God takes us through these things and he breaks our will. Gets us to these places. And he gets us there and he breaks our will. When you ain't got nothing else to do but to rely on him. Gets us there. And at the end of the day, if he don't get us out, we just ain't coming out of this. Takes us to those places. Just to show us, number one, that he's God. Number two, how stubborn we really are. And number three, that if we really say yes, he'll take us further than where we have been. Say that. One thing we also need to know is that God is patient with us during the spiritual growth process. He's patient with us. God takes time and he waits on us. Glory. I know you thought you should have been here by now. But if you don't realize it by now, God is patient with you. He's waiting. Glory to Jesus. Through all of the years of your life, he showed patience. When you were supposed to be at this level and you just wasn't going to go there, no matter what he said, you was just going to stay here. He's been patient with us. Won't you give God praise for his patience? Some of us ain't got no patience. Won't you give God praise for his patience? He's been patient with us. Glory. When we upset him, he doesn't just go off the handle. He waits. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Glory. He don't just go off. Glory. As soon as you do some things that ain't pleasing to him. Glory. You know how sometimes when you've had teachers, I'm not one of these teachers, because I don't even know sometimes when students are making mistakes. But anyway, when you had teachers and they're like, look, correct this right now. Now do you do that when they can't read. But anyway, that's a whole other story. But fact of the matter is, God is patient. He waits on us. Even when you don't get it right the first time, he has enough belief in you that you're going to get it right the next time. And guess what? When you mess up that time, he says, I'm going to give him one more chance. You're going to get it right this time. And when you mess up that time, I'm going to give you another chance. But you're going to get it right this time. He's patient. Hallelujah. Patient. Glory. He waits for us. Throughout this process, he knows we're going to get it together. One thing we also need to know is that his growth process is normally characterized by afflictions, disappointments. Somebody say disappointments. Failures. Frustrations. I want to say that one more time so it'll bring some things into perspective. God's growth process is characterized by afflictions. Everybody say afflictions. Disappointments. Failures. When you messed up. When you thought that time you really had it. And then it failed. When you studied and you still failed. When you really meant to pass it this time. And you still failed. Failures. And frustrations. I believe. Will you just lift your hands real quick? Because I believe God is taking us to a season where he's moving frustrations. You hear me, saints? Where he's moving frustration. Now, these other three I can work on. But sometimes frustrations get us a little bit stuck. Say amen. I can work on trying it again if I fail. I can work on my disappointments because I'm just going to do it one more time. Glory to God. I can work on the afflictions. I'm going to listen this time and do. But sometimes